Line movement exercises with Ms.Boley. A line is a dot that went for a walk. That is a quote from the artist Paul Klee. We are going to be working on using different kinds of lines that are made by using different parts of our hand and arm. So you will need a sheet of paper to practice on. It could be in your visual journal or just a loose sheet of paper. And it is optional to also use a sheet of construction paper or craft paper. And I'm actually using in the video a paper bag. I just got my groceries in a paper bag this week, and I cut the bag and I'm using that for this project. And you will need a marker for drawing your lines. I've used a couple of different kinds of markers, but just one is fine, or even a ballpoint pen, and some colors. So it could be markers or pencil crayons or whatever is easily available. All right, why are we doing this? Well, we're trying to review different types of lines, and we're trying to understand how to create different qualities of lines. We're also trying to see how, when lines overlap, they can create shapes. And this is also fun because it's really low pressure. We don't have to make it look like anything. It's abstract. I think it's going to be fun. Let's see kind of the difference that it makes when we use only certain parts of our arms and wrists, how it looks in the line that we draw. So this is an example of a line drawn only using finger and hand movements. So you're not moving your full arm. You're only allowed to move your finger and hand. So notice what kind of line is created. It's pretty small. And then here we have a line drawn using wrist movements. So we can see that the range is bigger because you're able to move your wrist. And then finally, full arm movements. So you can see that the line is actually going right off the paper because you're able to have that big range of motion with your full arm. All right, so let's give that a try. So pause the video, go grab your paper and marker or pen, and you're going to try to draw a line across your page using only finger and hand. So this is just for practice. So just try it out and see how it goes. You might start and realize that you're actually using more than your finger and hand, and that's fine. Just correct yourself and move on. All right. So now you're going to draw a line using your wrist. So you can do it on the same sheet of paper and just below the one that you just did, and draw a line using your wrist. You can still use your fingers and hands can still move, but you're allowed to move your wrist as well. So you can get that bigger range, back and forth motion. And I bet you that this line took you less time to draw than the previous one. And finally, we're going to do a line using your full arm. So I would recommend putting a sheet of paper underneath the paper you're drawing on, because your line will end up going off the paper. So put a sheet underneath so you don't end up drawing on your desk. And go ahead. So do a line using your full range of motion of your arm. So by now, you're gonna have three lines on your paper. This was just for practice. All right, wonderful. Now, we're going to create an artwork that combines all three of those motions in a little bit more of an on-purpose way. So let's get started on that. All right, so I have my construction paper, and I have a few different types of markers or tools to draw my lines with. So feel free to also use different drawing tools. And the first thing I'm gonna start doing is I'm gonna do that line that I'm making only using like my finger and my hand. So my motions are very small, and I'm kind of choosing where I want it to go on the paper. I'm not just gonna go straight across, but you can definitely just go straight across if you like. So there we go. I'm just drawing very slowly, taking my time, using only finger and hand motion. Part of the video was sped up. Now I'm gonna do my whole wrist. So see how I can get a larger range? I can use some of my forearm as well, but I'm not using my full arm at this point yet. So it's still a bit more controlled. I'm just gonna go right across the page. So there we go, full wrist. So this is the point you want to make sure you have a paper under your page, because we're going to do full arm motion. Whoa, so it's going to go off the page. And kind of do one line and then stop for a second and decide, am I going to do more or what? So after you've done the three, you're going to make some decisions. So should I do some more hand and wrist motions? Should I leave it as it is? I'm also going to go and pick out some lines to make into thicker lines and change the weight of the line so that it kind of stands out a bit more. So this is where I'm taking this exercise and making it into a piece of art. So I've decided to do another hand and wrist line, and then I'm going to use a thicker marker. I'm going to make some particular lines thicker. So that's what you will do as well. Make some artistic decisions. All right, I'm getting happy with it. I'm happy with it now, so I'm going to add some color in some of the spaces. So I've created some shapes by overlapping the lines. And I'm going to color some of them in. And this is why I chose to use the construction paper, because it looks really nice with the pencil crayon. But it's fine if you chose white paper as well. So you'll choose certain spaces and you will add color. And now I'm speeding up the video in time lapse. We're not picking all of the spaces to color in, because this artwork is really more about line than it is about color. And there we go. I cannot wait to see what you've created. Thank you so much for watching.